Welcome to the Armani Talks YouTube channel, the number one YouTube channel for you to level up your communication skills, learn the art of public speaking, social skills, and personal branding to take your message to the world. For today's episode, we're entering the world of social skills, and I'm going to be talking about the ambivert. The ambivert may be a label that we're not too familiar with. We are familiar with the extrovert and the introvert. Just a quick little summary on both of these parties. The extrovert is the individual who can be around a lot of people for a very long time and just get more and more energized. While for the introvert, the game is a little different. They can be around other people. However, after some time, they start getting more and more drained. They need to leave the social interaction, go and be by themselves for a little bit to recharge. Now, there are certain misconceptions regarding both parties. One of the misconceptions regarding extroverts is that all of them are very, very talkative. Is this the case? Not always. Have you ever had that one moment when you are in an event and you see that there's this one person who is always showing up? This particular person doesn't necessarily say too much, but they're always at those events. Well, this is a good example of a shy extrovert. Even though they don't say a lot of words, in reality, they still have extroverted tendencies. While one of the misconceptions regarding introverts is that they're not charismatic, that they don't know how to talk to other people, that they're socially awkward. This also couldn't be further from the truth. A lot of the most charismatic people that you know, you'll start to realize that they are introverts. When they are surrounded by others, they know how to carry themselves with class. They know how to speak. They know how to be graceful, tell jokes, all that stuff. But still, they need time to recharge. So once the event is winding down, they're more than happy to dip and be by themselves. Now, in these cases, you might be able to identify with either or party. And if you haven't identified already, I'm sure the Myers-Briggs exam has done it for you. In the Myers-Briggs exam, one of the most common things is that you are given a label. You're told whether or not you demonstrate extrovert qualities or whether or not you demonstrate introvert qualities. Now, at first, this may not seem like a bad thing. This is very similar to you deciding whether or not you're right-handed or you're left-handed. But the biggest mistake happens when we start to identify just with one part so much to a point where we feel as though we can ignore the other part. An example of this is, imagine that one day you're chilling at the bus stop. It's 9:10 p.m. at night and you're just chilling, minding your own business. Out of the blue moon, there's this big dude with a black hoodie that comes to you and is holding a big axe. And he asks you, would you like to keep your right arm or would you like to keep your left arm? You're gonna think, I wanna keep both. And the guy in the hoodie is like, no, you can only pick one. Which one is it? What is going to be happening with you is you're gonna be thinking, look, fam, I don't want you cutting off any one of my arms. I know I'm right-handed, but I still need my left hand. That's how you're going to be reacting, isn't it? Well, if that's the case, you have to apply that same sort of mentality into your personality. You may identify a little bit more with the extroverted label, or you may identify more with the introverted label. Whatever the case is, do not use this as an excuse to ignore the other side. Because if this is the case, then what you'll soon realize is that your charisma starts to suffer. What is the ambivert? We've already heard what the extrovert is about. We already heard what the introvert is about. What is the ambivert? Well, the ambivert is a mix between the two. It's a hybrid. An ambivert is defined as someone who has extroverted and introverted-like tendencies. And in reality, that's how we should be in the real world, especially in the very dynamic world of social intelligence. If you're someone that is extremely strict with your personality type. Let's say you're an introvert and you're like, all right, I've been in this event for 3 hours. I understand it's a very, very big event, but still, I'm an introvert. I can't be chilling for 4 hours at a certain event. And by simply having this belief, what happens is you keep thinking about it. You keep thinking about it more and more and more. You keep playing it back in your mind. So much to a point where eventually you're in the event physically, but mentally you're out of the game. And now when other people are starting to interact with you, you're thinking, oh my God, man, does he not understand that I'm an introvert? I don't want to talk. And you're basically taking yourself out of the race. In reality, what you should be doing is analyzing the situation around you. This right here is a very big event in context to your life. If that's the case, then why not use this as an opportunity to flex your personality muscles? If you naturally identify with an introvert and you are getting tired, then force yourself to be an extrovert in this particular situation. Force yourself to be more energized. Even if you don't feel like it, see if you can force yourself to feel like it. At first, this is going to feel grueling. You're going to be thinking, I don't want to do all this. This is annoying. I just want to stay comfortable in my label as an introvert. But no, no. You have to exercise your personality if you want to be dynamic. That's the case with the introvert. Now with the extrovert, there's certain individuals who can't be in the house for more than, like, say, 4 hours without going mad. They always have to be surrounded by other people. And talk to these people about something like creative writing, something like meditation. They automatically say, look, bro, I'm an extrovert. I always need to be around people. I can't do something like this. This is an activity that I have to do by myself. No, man. That's not how extroverts roll. And by acting like that, what happens to them is that they start talking themselves out of potential skill sets that they could be learning. That's not good. In this case, what this individual should do is mitigate the desire to want to hang out with other people so much. You can still hang out with people, but that's going to wait. You're going to do that later. First, you're going to take out a piece of paper and you're going to write. Whether you feel like it or not, you are going to write. And this individual right here is doing something that he or she naturally does not like doing. And this right here is another example of the extrovert now flexing his or her muscles to change their personality type as well. Ultimately, what happens is that the extroverted individual gets a lot of the fuel from the external world, while the introverted individual can get a lot of the fuel from the internal world. The ambivert is different because they're able to evaluate the scenario. What exactly is going on? Should I be a little bit more extroverted now? Or should I be a little bit more introverted right now? These are the sort of questions that the ambivert is asking himself or herself. Mega key, because one thing that you start realizing when you start networking with different people, once you start going in different clubs and a lot of these different environments, is that certain times there's a personality type that suits you to the T. And other times, there's a personality type that you're finding very difficult to vibe with. Whatever the case is, the charismatic person knows how to adjust. That's all social dynamics is all about. So absorb the life of an ambivert. Change it up. If you are heavily extroverted, try being an introvert. Try bringing introverted tendencies into your life. Analyze the Myers-Briggs exam and see what the character traits for each party is like. And if you're an introvert, then force yourself to be a little bit more extroverted. And what you'll start seeing is that these two worlds that you have been separating for the longest time start coming together and together. And at this point, these two worlds start complementing one another. As it starts complementing one another, that's when you have formed into an ambivert, a very rare creature in the social skills world. However, it's a creature that is able to build connections, build rapport with others, and be highly dynamic to spot opportunities that others would be blind to. Adopt the life of an ambivert, and if you would like more tips on how to level up your social intelligence, make sure you check out the Armani Archives, an in-depth look into the world of social dynamics. Grab your copy in the description box right on below. Thank you for joining the Armani Talks YouTube channel, and I'll catch you on the next episode.